The Washington Post did an interview with you where they had found some inconsistencies in his story as far as the years he owned the hotel.
Yeah.
You even say in the book that you can't vouch for everything he said. You call him out as an unreliable narrator. Do you think it's fair, then, for the Washington Post to call you out for getting facts wrong?
Well, it might be self-serving in the way I sound, but I'm not trying to be self-serving. The Washington Post is wrong. When I first got this news, I was broadside. I mean, I'm 84 now, but most of my life, from the time I was 20, I was a very careful reporter. I'm still a careful reporter. And they said, the Washington Post said, that during a period, this guy owned this motel for 37 years, for about 6 or 7, 8 years, from 1980, that's when after I left him, until about 86 or so, he didn't own the motel. Meaning, how can you not own the motel and try to write about as if you're in the motel? Mm-hmm. And I didn't know that, and I was very upset, and I said, well, I can't go along and to support this book. But the next day, I called the guy who bought the motel from the motel guy that I knew, and he said, no, I bought this motel from Gerald Foos, the guy, mm-hmm. but he still had access to it. He had the key, and he had the key all the way through the owners. Then he rebought the motel in 86. If I had known that day I was told about this Washington, what I know now, or what I knew the next day, I wouldn't have disavowed the book. That was a mistake in my part, but I overreacted. I was very angry and very embarrassed, too, because I took pride always in my life, a reliable reporter. That's what I am. And I wasn't what the Post said. But I don't blame the aggressiveness of reporters in trying to check the facts, because we all try to do that.
Well, in fact, that's important. I want to ask as well, you wrote an article for Esquire called Frank Sinatra Has a Cold. It got reprinted a bunch this year because it would have been his 100th birthday.
Right.
It is considered a turning point piece of journalism. You spent time with the Sinatra camp and the Sinatra people. When you were working on this piece that sort of advented this new form of journalism, did you know it was going to be a piece that would live on as long as it has?
No. I've written so many pieces, and I never know what the public is going to like or remember. In my 65 years as a reporter, the only time I really enjoyed talking to someone, I know you have a wonderful experience talking to everybody every night, and you love them all.
Yes.
I didn't love any of them except Peter O'Toole.
Peter O'Toole.
And he affected my life. First of all, he'd done Lawrence of Arabia, and I went to London, where he lived, interview him, and he said, we have to go to Ireland. So he let me go with him to Ireland, and not that we drank all the time. We drank much of the time.
Uh-huh.
But much of the time when we weren't drinking, so surprising, a superstar actor, great actor, he'd ask me about myself. And God, I'm the interviewer. No, he's interviewing me. And he said, are you married? I said, yes, I'm married in 1959, and I'm married to the same woman tonight, as of tonight. I think.
Yeah, let's
go. I'm gonna get home, I have to check. But anyway, he said, you have any children? I said, no, we've been married 4 years. My wife is also a Catholic family, an Irish Catholic family. And I said, no, I'm a reporter, I can't afford it. You can't afford it? No, I can't afford a child. You know, you're not a risk taker, are you? He said, I have a child, and I'm an actor. Well, I'm not a risk taker, I just didn't think I could afford it. Well, why don't you just change and do it? Why don't you just do it, Nike commercial, just try it, do it. And he said, why don't you have your wife come over and stay with us in London. My wife would be glad to have you as a guest. So I call my wife, Nantelise. I said, hey, Peter O'Toole, and his wife is Sean, she was an actress as well, welcome us for a week. Nan flew over, and we had this wonderful guest room. And during that 6-day period, as the guest of Peter and Sean Phillips, was the wife and actress, we conceived our first child.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, Pamela was born in 64, 9 months after the Peter O'Toole invitation. And I think today he created my not being so much of afraid of not having enough money.
Well, that's why it breaks my heart to tell you this. He watched you guys conceive the baby from.